Hi guys, welcome back to my channel. Thank you so much for being here. I appreciate you for clicking on this video and giving it a watch. If you haven't already, please consider hitting that subscribe button and joining my YouTube family. Also, don't forget to hit the like button down below as well as leave a comment because all of those things do help my channel grow. Don't forget to keep Frugal Jay in your prayers. If you haven't already, head over to her channel, give her a subscribe, watch her videos, including the ads, because she is making her current income just off of YouTube, and we don't make much at all. But the way YouTubers do make money is by watching the ads. And so if you could go over and give her a help out with that. She is in Chicago. I think she went back. She was kind of back and forth between Florida and Chicago because of health stuff and things, but she is not currently working her regular job because she's been helping her family deal with an accident that her son got into. And so she is just an amazing, amazing, kind woman. So please give her all the support you can. There's a GoFundMe that Everything Mari opened, and that is also linked down below. Today for you, I have a Dollar Tree haul. It is going to be a mostly school supply Dollar Tree haul because we are in it. The kids are getting ready to go back to school. I have been buying them stuff. This should be my last haul with school supplies involved because they're going back. Like, it's time. So let's get started. I do have just a couple things that aren't school supplies, but I was really excited to share with you. So I'm going to do those first, and then we'll get into it. I mean, it's not all school supplies, but I got it for the kids for school. But first I found this and I was so excited. So I did find already the egg slicer, and now I found the 3-in-1 avo tool. I love avocados, I love guacamole, I love all those things, and so I'm excited to give this a try. So it says that you have this right here to give it a slice, you have this right here to get the pit out, and then this to get to cut it into avocado strips. And so I'm gonna give that a try with my next avocado that I pick up. So it's a 3-in-1, you just get it all done with this, and then you don't have to pull out a knife and then like a spoon to dig it out. And sometimes I use a butter knife to cut it, but then I need a sharp knife to get the pit out. So I'm gonna try this and see if it works as an all-in-one. So I'm excited for that. I also found, and now this stuff was tricky to me, and I need to find the receipt and see what I spent. I found Autoban. My husband, he's working on starting a carpet cleaning business. I've mentioned that a little bit. And so he kind of knows his stuff when it comes to carpet cleaning stuff and like deodorizers and that kind of thing. And he likes this Autoban stuff. I saw it sitting there and I was like, wait a second. I had to call him and ask him because we already own some, but it's the lavender scent. And this one is original eucalyptus scent. And he spends much more than $1.25 when he purchases it. However, the reason I need to look at my receipt is I found it in the regular section at one of my stores, and then literally like the next store or the next like store after that, I found it and it was in their plus section with a $3 sticker on it. And then when I was in Wyoming, I saw it at one of the stores there in the $3 section, and in another store there in the regular section. So I haven't found my receipt for this particular store. It's not in the bag with this, but I need to look and see if this was $1.25 or $3 where I picked it up. I think $3 is still a good deal. If I remember, no promises. I'll pop up a price tag here, like of how much I found it online for. But either way, my husband likes it. He thinks it's a good disinfectant and air freshener. And so like if my dogs have an accident or anything like that, we spray this to help make it smell better. Or if the kids, you know, are just a mess or anything like that. So I picked up two of those. Because one, I thought they were $1.25. I think, I hope that they were $1.25 when I picked them up. And my husband likes them, he uses them. So I figured we should have them. Now also not school supply related, but in this haul, I picked up some of the medicine from the Dollar Tree. So this one is the daytime cold and flu relief. And then this one is the Tussin mucus and chest congestion. So my son got a little summertime cold, not COVID. We tested for it. I even took him in for like a lab one just to make sure. And it's not COVID, but he has a lingering cough from it. And so I wanted to get him some stuff to help out the cough. He probably doesn't need this one because I don't think he's like sick anymore. He doesn't have the cold anymore. He just has that really annoying lingering cough. And so anything I can do to kind of help him out, I should have picked up cough drops and I didn't do that. But and then that way we have that on hand, because it feels like whenever we need medicine, we don't have it on hand. I picked up some strawberry preserves, kind of school related, because peanut butter and jelly sandwiches are heading our way, because that is what the kids typically like when they take their packed lunches. And so I got these. I thought $1.25 was a great deal. They're good until March of 2024. And I wish I could remember who. Lorelei prefers strawberry, Eric and Braxton prefer grape, or Eric prefers strawberry and Braxton and Lorelei prefer grape. I can't remember. One of them prefers strawberry, two of them prefer grape. So we typically try to have both in the house for them. And then I thought these would be fun for a snack to take, because the kids all need a snack to take to school every day. And they are a 10 pack of animal crackers. And how do you do wrong with animal crackers? So I also love these types of animal crackers. I don't love the frosted ones. I like these ones. And so I'm going to give these a try and hopefully they're good. It looks a little blurry on camera, but 10 packs, you get 0.8 ounces in each packet, and they're 110 calories each packet. So I thought that would be good for a school snack for the upcoming school year. Okay, so now, if you've been here, you've been hearing me talk about Lorelei and the strawberry theme, and I still have not found the strawberry composition notebooks. I probably have tried 15 stores. 12 to 15, I would say, stores in different areas. I don't think that the composition notebooks came to Colorado. That's where I'm going with it, because I cannot find them anywhere. All I find is the other set that has some of the other stuff in it. So anyway, I did find this one. It's like a little three-ring binder. This isn't on her school supply list, but I picked it up anyway because it's strawberries and that's her theme this year. This print is so cute. I wish I could find the composition notebooks, but we're gonna make do with what I found. And what I found is just a bunch of really cute ones. And then I bought her strawberry stickers, and I have the Cricut, and I can Cricut strawberries for her to decorate things. So we're gonna go through her stuff today. We're gonna see, you know, and kind of where we're gonna go with it. So this one says, "It's a great day to do great things." Love that. This one says, "Radiate positivity." Love that. These are all Jot. They come with 100 sheets, and I'm pretty sure they're wide ruled in them. And her school specifically asked for composition notebooks. So this one says, "Follow the rainbow." Super cute. This one has flowers and kind of the rainbow. And then this one says, "Wild at heart." And this is one of her favorite colors. So two of these two are Crown Jewels, not Jot brand. So they're Crown Jewels. They don't tell you how many pages. They might actually be a little bit less, but so two different things. So I'll let her kind of go through it. We'll figure out what she wants to do with her notebook, since I can't find the strawberry ones for her. I'll continue looking until like the time comes, but I'm calling it a loss because I have not been able to find them, and I have been searching. So between Lorelei and Braxton, they all needed folders. I did pick some up at Target. I didn't haul those in my collective haul because, I mean, that's kind of boring. But I'll show you the ones I picked up at Dollar Tree. I did grab these before I went to Target. I got these ones for Lorelei. They asked for the three-prong ones, and they were a better deal at Target. So just note that if you're looking for these plasticky folders with the three prongs, they're a better deal at Target. But I had went to Dollar Tree first, and I grabbed red, purple, and this is green, but it's kind of like a turquoisey green. So it was a pretty green. And then I got other solid ones, and I can't find anything with the strawberry. So we can decorate those up strawberry if that's what she feels like she wants to do. And then for Braxton, I also got him all the solid colors from Target. But from Dollar Tree, I found this one. I thought it was fun, and he said he liked it. And it's just got all the different little pictures all over it. He's doing kind of the video game theme. This doesn't fully fall into that, but I mean, it's cute. And so he can use it. This one doesn't have the three prongs. It just has the two folders on the inside. And the back has a big skull and crossbone that says nope. And then this one I thought was cute as well. And with the video game theme, and it gave it a little bit something more than just a plain folder. It has the prongs and the little pockets. So those are the folders I picked up. This I got for me. It's it's a three pack of button file bags. So I use this kind of stuff for receipts. I use it for important papers, things like that I want to sort into different piles. And so this was a three pack, which is a killer deal. I thought it was a two pack. But no, they're sitting in there. That's awesome. So they're just little solid color file folders to stick stuff in. One more notebook. So Braxton, they asked for spiral notebooks for him, and I have managed to pick him up a ton of composition notebooks. So we'll see if at any point they ask for composition notebooks. If not, we still have a bunch on hand. He can use them at home if he feels like he wants to, or we could just set them aside and see if next year they need them. But that one was really cute and a different print than any of the other ones I had picked up. And this one is also by Jot with 100 pages. So, you know, you never know if they, through the year, say that they're going to need something. When I was looking at stuff, I found this coloring book. It's inspirational quotes coloring book, just for fun, to relax, for a gift, with friends, whatever you need, reasons you need to color. So this is by Bendon, which is in Ohio, made in the USA. I don't love the cover, but I really liked the quotes. It says, do what you love. This would be great in a gift basket. However, the cover is not nearly as cute. It says, love is the perfect seasoning for any recipe. And they are one-sided, so you can color and give it to somebody or whatever you want to do with them. Work like a captain, play like a pirate. Sounds like Eric on that one. And this one says, I can and I will. So, I don't know, I might, you know, the kids are going back to school, I have a little bit more time. And so I just thought it was really neat. I like inspirational quotes. That's kind of my jam. Back to the strawberries. I believe I have picked up and hauled the mirror. That was the strawberry mirror, because I think it's in the school supply thing, the things I've already hauled. And I did get the cork board one. And then now I also decided to pick her up the whiteboard, the dry erase, because why not? And so she has the whole set, but she doesn't have a locker. It's silly, I know, but you know, when you can find the stuff at the Dollar Tree, she has mentioned about she wants to do strawberries for the next 2 years, and that means that we will be ahead of the game for next year when she's in middle school. And even if she doesn't, I mean, we can hang some of the stuff up in her room, because why not? So this whole Adore brand, I have found just bits and pieces in so many different stores and never just all in one, because that's how that always works, right? I found the little photo frame pieces in Wyoming, never in Colorado, and I found just all the sticky notes I found in several places, but I picked them up a long time ago. And now I found the bookmarks. And so it comes with the peach, the flower, the strawberry, and the rainbow. And so I got one set for Lorelai, and I got one set for me too, because I like to read, and I think that these bookmarks are adorable, and I always really like the magnetic bookmarks. And so we can put that in with her school supplies. And then if I even just keep like the one or two that I like, I can give her the extras and she can have some at home and some at school or however she wants to do it. I picked up this batch of really fun pencils. They're the Zebra brand, so name brand pencils. They're number 2 refillable with 0.7 lead. And I just thought these were really cute, so maybe Lorelai and I can share them. We can each get one of the prints because it comes with 8, which is such a good deal. So grab those. And then they also had these ones too. This is also an 8-pack, and it's kind of the gold decoration ones and super cute. So I grabbed those. I figure I'll probably share them with her. These I think I picked up for Brax. And I did. I asked him if he wanted them. And they're like the double-sided highlighters. Highlighters weren't on his list, but I thought that they might be good for him to have in his pencil box. And I liked that they were double-sided. So one of them is yellow and orange, and one of them is blue and orange. And so then he has the 4 colors, but it's in two things. Another set of pencils for Lorelai. I will steal one of the avocado ones because I like the avocado, or both. But she likes this type of pencil where you know, pull the one piece of lead out and put one in. And she asked me if you could buy refills of those leads. And I'm like, well, no, not really, because she has a pencil that she used them all up. So now she has a whole nother set of these ones. They have the avocado, the peaches, and the rainbows. They missed the strawberry, of course, but still super cute. So I got them for her anyway. Lots of pens and pencils in this batch. I picked up the pink set of these and I like them so much. So I picked up the purple ones as well to add. So it has purple and lavender. They're the Ink Brand Optimus Fine Point Felt Tip Pens. And I really liked them. So I picked up myself a couple more. I picked up Braxton some of these Precision 2 rollerball pens in case he decides he wants some pens either for at home to do homework or at school. I don't know what the rules are on pens, but I grabbed those for him to add in. Lorelai, so a little bit of a vent. So her school supply list, there's a lot on it. And her gym class asked from every student for them to bring dry erase markers. Every student in an elementary school, K through 5, the gym teacher needs dry erase markers. So Expo dry erase markers aren't cheap. They're like $4.89, I think, is what I spent on the packs. I'm like, you know what? If the gym teacher, mind you, gym, PE class, they can have some jaw ones because that is a lot. Let's say that there are 300 students in the school, which I think is roughly give or take, and each student brings a pack of four. That is 1,200, I think I math that right, 1,200 dry erase markers for the PE teacher for 1 year. I just thought that was crazy. So this one is the 8-pack, so I was like, well, that's cool, you get a little bit more. I know the Dollar Tree ones don't last nearly as long as Expo. I do know that from experience. But for a PE teacher, I think it's crazy to need that many dry erase markers, unless she's the holder of all the dry erase markers for the school, I don't know. But to save a little bit of money in my pocket, the gym teacher gets Jot. The teacher homeroom gets Expo. I got those from Target. Braxton is in middle school and he has a locker and he has some decorative magnets for it. And then I asked him if he wanted these in case he wants to hang anything up. And he said yes. So he's just gonna use these in his locker to hang up, you know, anything like notes or anything like that he needs to. I have talked a bit about using my Cricut to put designs on things for the kids. So I got a light gray and this pretty pink color is a new one. They should both be, yep, they're both permanent. I haven't tried the removable vinyl in a while from Crafter Square. When I have tried it, it gave me a lot of hassle. So I didn't like the removable, but I can make the permanent vinyl work. I feel like if it's really small and intricate, it gives me a hard time. But if it's like kind of big bubbly letters, it typically works. And so I haven't had any major problems. I've had some, but not major problems with their vinyl. So I use it when I can. And so I thought that pink would go cute for some strawberry things. And when we start kind of vinyling her stuff, which needs to be soon because school's about to start, I'll ask her, does she want red? Because I already have red. I have green. I have that pink. I have a shiny pink. So I have color options. So we'll figure out kind of what direction she wants to go with that. Not really school supplies, but I did find her some hair ties. She is big on scrunchies right now. And these ones kind of have that tie-dye kind of look. And they came on a rack of their own. They're not really branded. This isn't branded at all. But I figured she would probably like these, so I picked them up for her. And then she doesn't usually wear headbands, but we'll see. But I picked it up because it's strawberry. I did get her the strawberry scrunchies. They weren't Scrunchie brand, though. They were a different brand. And I mean, this kind of goes really well with it because they were striped with strawberries on them. But we'll see if she wants to wear this as a headband. She can use it as a hair tie because it has some elastic on it. She can be creative. I don't know, but I thought it was cute and it went with her strawberry theme. So I picked that up for her. She got really spoiled this year, I would say, because Dollar Tree just did it up with the strawberry stuff. This was on my wish list to find, and I didn't find it at all. And at one store, in the little fun find circular, I guess rectangle, because it wasn't the circle one, but they're fun find. Like some of my stores have like a fun find wall, and some of them just have like a fun find display. There's literally only one strawberry pin in there, and I knew they existed, but I wasn't finding them anywhere. So I was really excited to find it, just to add it to her pen collection. It writes in black and it writes really smooth. So that is awesome. And I was glad to find it for her. So let's see, I got her a red gel one from Target. I got this one. I found one of the ones that's from the Adore brand that had the strawberry on it. She's got a ridiculous amount of strawberry pens now. And then to add to her pen problem that I am creating, I found this that is a rainbow. They did not have this in the strawberry, but they had the rainbow. They had other ones too, and I, off the top of my head, can't remember what all the ones were for this. a peach maybe, because if I look at this, so it comes with this brand, but this one's the rainbow pen. I can't remember if it was the peach, if they had a flower. I can't remember what all they had for it, but I thought she would probably like the rainbow the best. So I picked that pen up for her. Oh, because I have a problem with pens. She doesn't know that I bought them yet. She likes tie-dye and like the galaxy print a lot, so I thought she would probably like these. And they are the Zeba brand again. And it says that they have assorted ink and they're medium point. And I assume that that means it's a purple and a pink one to go with the color of the container or the pen. But I suppose we could just try it out real fast. So they're both tie-dye, which she will love. They're even cuter outside of the packaging. Yep, so this one is pink. They have the little wax ball at the bottom, so if you try to pull them out, remember that, to hold the ink in. And that one is purple. So they are the color of the ink of what they say. And I was bummed I would have got some for Braxton, but they were all very, like, no, girly designs, and then I don't think he'd want to write in pink and purple, so I didn't get him a set because they didn't have any for him. But those were really cute, so we're gonna add those to her school. So this is in their school supply section right now. It is magnetic, and it is a magnetic locker box pocket, it says. But I got it because I have a dry erase boards on my refrigerator, and right now I have the suction cup little cup that holds all my dry erase pens in there to be able to use all my dry erase calendars. But this has two pockets as opposed to just the one, and it's a magnet, so I think it'll stay up better because every so often that one likes to pop off since it's just the suction cup kind. And this color matches better. I have a pink one up right now, so I picked this up, and I will, now that I hauled it, put it on there, put my dry erase markers in there, decide if I want another one for just like pens and stuff on the fridge. Because, you know, when you're always digging through junk drawers or wherever trying to find just a pen to write a quick note, this would be a nice way to have that option. So I got that for the refrigerator. I picked up the hand sanitizer from Dollar Tree. So I did look at Target, and they had the size that is probably about two sizes bigger than this. Like, I mean, just a little bit bigger. And they were like $7 each. And I was like, oh, that's more than I want to spend on hand sanitizer. So instead, I bought two for each kiddo, two for Lorelai, two for Braxton. And I'm going to send these instead. So they get a total of 16 fluid ounces, but it was a total of $2.50 instead of, like, even if I said half of the other one. So I feel better about this cost. And then later on in the school year, I can send more if they need more. The one thing I do need to still buy for them, though, is tissues. And I need to get those sent off to the school. So I got four of the hand sanitizers. So this lotion, it's the Palmer's Coconut Oil Body Lotion, 24-hour moisture. I love this. I have it in my purse. It's almost gone because whenever, like, I forget to put lotion on, or if I wash my hands at the store, or if I use the restroom anywhere, public restroom, and I wash my hands and the soap's always really drying. I love this, and I love the smell of this so much. It smells so good. So I always like to have this on hand. I don't think $1.25 is like a great price, but I don't think it's terrible for Palmer's either. So that is my purse lotion, and I needed to replace it. It smells so good. The kids want to make some sort of craft. Paper squishies, I think they call them. Paper squishies. So they take paper and they draw a picture on it, and they fill it full of old plastic bags. And since I Dollar Tree shop all the time, I typically have like a handful of plastic bags, and they make their own squishies, and then they cover it with tape. And so they needed some tape. They've been asking me to make them. So I got them their own roll of tape to make their own paper squishies. So that way they can do that and stop asking me, because I needed to buy them tape for that. Braxton wanted some whiteout for his school supplies, so we just got him the Bic correction tape. This is my favorite stuff too. I love it when I find it at the Dollar Tree, and so we're gonna add that into his school supplies. And then lastly, I picked up some of these pencil boxes. I already hauled the ones, they were pink and sparkly all in there. I love those. I found those in Wyoming. These ones are the only ones that I've been seeing so far in Colorado, but these are for school supplies. And I bought a little kind of hand container, but I was like, wait, I'm gonna use this, fill it with like the colored pencils, and we have crayons, and whatever else, so then they can stack. So like Eric usually uses colored pencils when he does his homework, and he can find the colored pencil ones. I may or may not label it with my Cricut. We'll see how crafty I'm feeling. But I got three in the teal kind of green color, mint green, because it matches my office area really well. So I got three in that for school supplies to kind of help organize them. And then I got two with the pink lids, and these are to help organize my makeup, my like extra makeups, my stockpile in my bedroom and bathroom, because I think that they'll be really good to put the stuff in and be able to stack them. And so I got four total so far, because I got two that look like this and two that are like the sparkly pink. And so I'm going to start organizing it, see if I need to pick up more before they're gone, because usually with these cool, like the pretty color things, like you get them and then they're gone, and then they'll come out with a different color and you won't find the same color scheme again next time. So it's time to sort it and organize it, figure out if I need to pick up more before they disappear. So guys, that is it. That is my school supply Dollar Tree haul. Hopefully this is the last you hear about school supplies from me. If I find the strawberry composition notebooks, you know you'll see those, because I'll get really excited. But I think I've picked up pretty much everything else strawberry that exists, or at least that I can find. And time now to sort them all out, get them to the kids so that they could go to school, because it's back to school. Braxton goes back on the 8th, and you may or may not be seeing this on the day that he goes back to school. I had to do three hauls. Being out of town, I'm behind schedule on my haul, so I already have the stuff. I just need to show you guys. But he goes back to school on the 8th, and then the kiddos go back on the 12th because they're in two different school districts. And then I will have a quiet house throughout the week, which will be strange. Like right now, the kids are up building Legos because it's a day that they're home. And so today's Thursday. I've done three hauls. You'll see my white shirt. One of them was from, I had my hoodie on from Wyoming, but today's Thursday. We're going to go to the pool, like the community pool, tomorrow on Friday. We're going to go do a beach day on Saturday to kind of celebrate the end of summer. Braxton needs to go get a haircut. He's growing a mullet. It cracks me up. So we're going to go get a haircut probably on Sunday. And then he starts school Monday. Like, I don't know. I don't think I'm ready. I feel like it went too fast, but you know, it is what it is. All right, guys, that's enough chatting. I will see you guys next time. Thank you again so, so much for being here with me. I hope you guys are having a wonderful, wonderful day, and I'll see you next time. Bye, guys.